Sorry, we're broadcasting. What's your yelp? Come with your broadcast, try lowering the
broadcast. Yeah, it catches up. Loading. Tap for the room. We need a D-tap for the room.
Finally.
Hey, guys.
All right, we are we're getting ready here. We're gonna get going in just a minute. You can see us. My name is Larry Hryb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. This is the ever popular Jeffrey Mustaine. Jeffrey,
not even popular in my own home. Hi.
Hi. So, Jeff and I were just talking before we do. Hopefully, you watched the Periscope a little earlier. We're talking about the fact that a year ago, yesterday, we were in Alamogordo, New Mexico. Jeff.
Whoa.
And I,
what was it? 30th I've ever been.
All right, Dirty Jeff, we are going to play some State of Decay right now. Now, I want to point out, first of all, this is coming to Xbox One and PC on Wednesday of this
tonight.
Week.
Tonight.
Yes. Wow, okay.
Starting, if you digitally pre-ordered or you plan on picking up digitally, tonight at 9 p.m. Pacific, midnight Eastern. And if you're in Australia or New Zealand, you're already playing.
Right. So you're playing it, and we are going to... You're probably further in the game than anybody else streaming it right now, because how many hours have you played?
Myself or Greg Miller, yeah, I'm about 10, 12 hours in, would say.
So you're 10 to 12 hours in, so I want to warn you guys, first of all, if you plan on picking this up, and you haven't played on 360 before PC, there may be some spoilers.
Yeah, there's no way around that.
So, I want to point out. So let's back up a little bit.
Sure.
All the way up. Let's talk about what the game is and get people, bring people up to speed. So
sure.
This game, it's a zombie survival.
It is a zombie survival fantasy game. So just imagine that.
There's unicorns. That's the fantasy.
I think the fantasy is, and this is something that we think about, like what you hear about. Oh, there's a disaster took place, or if there was a zombie, if there was a zombie invasion, I know I would survive.
Right.
This is what I would do. This sort of gives you that chance to live that fantasy out. What would you do? Would you go and you would find a warehouse, as we did here, to hunker down in? You would find some survivors. You would grow crops. In fact, let me just take down my base.
But I want to point out, if you've played, for instance, any other type of zombie games, right? This is very different. And let's talk about it's different.
Yeah, so this is not a game where you're necessarily cobbling together. And I'm a huge zombie game fan, but you're not going to be putting together a chainsaw with a hockey stick and making and just blowing your way through 10,000 zombies. That's not
which is
happen.
Fun.
Oh, a huge fun. I'm a huge fan of games like that. It is not.
It's Charlie a game Six. Where we're route to the carnival, requesting access. Hello. Watchtower. Will you assholes stop jerking off and open the damn gates?
You're playing as
Come
Marcus.
Come on, goddammit, we're right here on the bridge. How do you not see
all of a sudden
us?
It's like, well, what is going
Charlie
on?
Charlie Six to anyone receiving. Where the hell is
sort of
everybody?
Where you're at now. So I'm pretty far into the game. I moved my base. A lot of people have seen the church.
You're well way past the
I'm
church.
I'm way past that. I moved
not
my
being room. Not being religious. You moved away from the church.
Well, I just felt like I was found shelter there at first.
Right.
But eventually, we just had too many.
Now you have found God in a warehouse.
In a warehouse, on the edge, of Marshall, the town of Marshall, which is lit up with watchtowers, with a kitchen.
Wait a minute. Okay, so there may be some people tuning in that have not seen the game ever.
Sure.
Let's go out to the map.
Let's go to the map.
Okay, so this is the whole play area.
This area over here is where you first start in the game,
okay.
and eventually you end up making a and this is where you start out, but eventually you end up recruiting too many folks. Not enough room. People don't have enough room to sleep. They start getting restless. And at some point, I scouted out. I came all the way over here down into Marshall. Marshall's the biggest area, the biggest town of the game. And over here on the outskirts, I found this warehouse. And it had a lot of room to grow. And it had room for people and a lot of facilities I could put in there. And also, I have close proximity. See, I marked all of these different things. Sources of fuel, sources of fuel. That's a really good place. It's very handy.
Now, is this the entire map here?
This is the entire map here, or the original State of Decay.
Okay.
Now, It also comes with Lifeline and Breakdown. Lifeline has a separate map. Breakdown
okay.
also takes.
So it's really three games in one.
Yes. Okay. So it's all the DLC, everything that's ever come out. First Day of Decay on Xbox 360 or PC. Plus, you have some new weapons. This character I'm using here, this is Urabani Carr. She is somebody that if you ever played on Xbox 360, as soon as you load up, you're going to find in your radio menu. This down on the D-pad, you see the radio menu. I have a lot of stuff here, but
what's going on here?
Sure. At the beginning of the game, you basically have the opportunity to call for scavengers. Like, let's say you find a place that has some ammo, but really it's just too hot of a scene for you. You can send some rooks in there. You can establish an outpost if you want to. What I had done on the map here is, you see, I established a number of outposts around my base that sort of make like a clear area where there's a lot fewer zombies. There's traps. So if a horde of zombies comes through,
right, so they're never going to get to your main base.
It's going
to
be very difficult. There's times.
Now, are they always going to come from this direction?
They might come over here. Sometimes a horde will come down this way. Right. But for the most part, this is a pretty well defensible area, and this is all mountains.
You know, if we don't help out soon, it may be
so
too late.
That area is pretty good.
And time's not exactly on our side.
Would you consider this game? I mean, it's a zombie survival game. Is it more like a tower defense game?
It's interesting because there's actually tower defense elements in certain. Especially with Lifeline. In this particular mode,
you leave the door open. That
makes sense. Oh, it makes it a little easier to get in. But watchtower there, right here. And
right.
Whoever's up there, there's generally someone up there who's really good. Is really good at shooting. Zombie or two will come through here. You generally will not get the big.
All right, Jeff's going to play a little bit here. If you're in the chat room, we're going to be giving away copies of the digital copies of the game, free. So just hang out in the chat room for a little bit. Call your friends, wake the neighbors, come on in, where we're playing a little bit of a State of Decay Year 1 Edition. This is coming to Xbox One and Steam this week. All right, Jeff, where are we?
All right, so first thing I'm going to do is I was asked for a diversion request. Somebody.
I'll check this out next. Be careful. There are a lot of infestations out there.
An ally is trapped somewhere and needs help getting out. So we're asking for a diversion. Or start hunting. That will give them a chance. Or if I'm not fast enough, they may kill that person.
I see. So you're basically on a quasi escort mission.
Yeah. There's a lot of things that happen. There are main story modes. But there are a lot of things that happen. Where if you're not on it quickly, then that person may. I'm just gonna drive these.
Driving like your 80-year-old self.
So here I'm honking.
Right,
hopefully,
see on the left hand side.
Yeah, there's a bunch
progress.
Of zombies behind me. Yes. Okay. So probably snuck out the back door. And I'll take. That's like a pretty minor thing that
right.
if you didn't do. That person might die.
Right.
So there's a lot of sort of like balancing your time. Hear those things and don't let them.
All right. So just a reminder, if you just tuned in, we're gonna be giving away some codes. If you want to go ahead and pre-purchase it and pre-download it, you can do that right now. If you bought the Xbox 360 version, you get the Xbox One version at a tremendous discount. It's like $20.
It's 33% off. So it's just a shade of.
$20 you get not one, not two, but all three. Now these other modes are not available in Xbox 360.
You might want to go check.
So the modes are there's
going on down
DLC,
right,
but
right,
then
right.
A number of things like this character, very weapons, and there's an where it's very in different places. You get a strange radio signal, swarming with zombies. You get in there and you hear them out, then you're going to find something.
This looks nothing like Alamogordo.
Hence the sarcasm.
No, it doesn't. I'm just saying. Although we did have that one mountain range.
Yeah.
I just remember that.
It takes place somewhere in America. I think somewhere.
Everywhere. USA.
Well, right now, I was radioed. There's a faction of the military.
How do you know where to go? Can you open up the map?
If you look at the green arrow, that sort of direction.
In
there's no GPS, but I know I'm heading up in this direction. So
there's no GPS.
It.
The zombies have knocked out the satellites. We're off. GPS is offline.
Right, we're off. Cell phones. It's actually kind of monstrous. That big dude. That's what you want to stay away from. could actually wreck the car. If I hit him with the car would
That's
take the brunt
news.
Of the damage.
Okay.
So coming up here, Sergeant Eric Tan is the mission here. He's someone I've been dealing with where the military is not taking kindly to the fact that a lot of the civilians are arming themselves.
Right.
But he sort of sympathizes. He understands it's rough out there on
right.
the street. So he has been very helpful, and in fact, I can actually call him once a day thanks to him. And so if things get crazy, I've had to do it.
And is it a full blanket splat?
You throw down a smoke flare, and you get the heck out.
Get the heck out.
So he's called on me. Now, there's an area back here where I first started, and there's another town here. Which is
awesome. So you haven't really investigated that town?
I have not been over here.
All right, if you want to hit us up on Twitter, hit me up at Major Nelson. You can find me there or, of course, here in the Twitch room. Also, reminder.
Come on, you limp dick sons of hippies.
I'll tell you how you're going to
win. Goddamn gate.
Bye.
Everything okay?
Bastards aren't opening the gates. Meanwhile, my boys are sitting out here like a goddamn mobile brain buffet. So, no, everything's pretty much not okay.
You don't look so good.
I'm fine. Had worse the day after I learned to say red light district in German. You throw a guy out on his ass for a case of the sniffles?
All right.
What kind of an army are you running?
There's nobody up there.
Garibani, she's yeah. who you get if you
Why do you think I'm trying so hard to get the gate open?
It'll know, and you'll be able to
Here's
radio her in when you get to the
you
church.
You want to see what's
she's
over there?
She's pretty awesome
the
because
big, bad
she
army
has
been doing
a,
while you civilians were stuck on this side of the river?
Rifle that has an integrated suppressor that doesn't wear
barricades down.
Anytime, you know, there's sort of a tendency, there's a lot of guns in the game.
Come on.
Shooting like crazy, but really...
Everybody,
you want to fire your
Let's
gun
move.
As infrequently as possible, because it makes a lot of noise.
Fire
but having a suppressed
hole.
Gun not attract more zombies. Some
right.
of the bigger stuff. Sometimes you just have to do it to survive. But a shotgun is just going to cause more problems.
Either way.
So you've opened
Let's
up
move.
This part of the map now.
Yeah. So there's an area in here, the fairgrounds.
No. Bad things happen at fairgrounds.
Well,
it is a documented
there's
fact.
I'm going to ask. Yes.
Yes,
it does.
Okay.
So
let's light them up. Light up the gumball machine. All right, if you guys want to win a code, here's the deal. Just be cool in the chat room, all right? If you start spamming and asking the same question over and over and basically not being cool, then you are going to be disqualified, so... Behave!
Survey point, I'm going to go back to you. This is an area that's very secluded, and I think that having done some readings, Ryan may want to set up my base. By the way, this SUV here is great.
It's the pink funmobile.
Some new large vehicles that are like super effective. Good use of vehicles is.
There.
Zombies up ahead. Go through or go around.
Alright, we're watching the chat room. We've got that up here as well, guys and girls. So if you got any questions, Jeff will be happy to answer them.
Garibani here, this character, she also comes with a couple of ransom. That are they get the job done. It seems pretty light, so. I actually do a much more hand-to-hand fighting in this game. Quiet.
Right.
But I need to get my shooting levels up.
Alright, we are... So is this now a base?
Alright, no, yeah. I'd have to determine if I want to make it a base.
Right.
Kicked us to the curb. So... I
in the woods like an unwanted puppy.
Do that, you have to
so,
have a certain amount of population, you have to have a certain amount
do
of building
whatever
supplies.
It is you do.
I may or may not have that much right now.
We're going to give away code right now, so keep an eye on the chat room there, gang.
I'm going up to HQ to find out
what's if you have this minimized in the background while you're sitting at your desk with your headphones on, it's time to switch over to that browser. Make sure your boss isn't watching.
They're setting up a bit of a group here. So they were sort of different faction of the army, and at some point I know they're going to be calling me in. They're going to want to be. What I'm going to want to do is go over to this survey point. Take a look. Let's see what's in the area. There's some SWAT team zombies. And they're still out of all... So there's five different kind of freak zombies. These guys are normal. It's going to be hard for them to take you down by themselves. A large group will do it. Character in particular is built up very strongly. She's almost completely maxed out. And so I'm like super paranoid about getting permadeath in the game.
So let's talk about that, because what a lot of folks don't realize is that you as you go through the game, you collect and you, I don't want to say earn characters. That's not fair.
No,
you earn their trust.
You rescue them. You earn their trust. They may join you.
So what happens is if you die, then you lose that character. Now, different characters in the game that you can switch to, and how do you switch characters?
Oh, yeah. There's a couple different ways. One is you just go up to them and say, hey, take over for me. And the other way is... you go up on the various builds.
Oh, I remember this.
This is the sort of the balance. Something just popped up in the upper right. Oh. So this is the type of thing that you need to balance, which can be kind of challenging.
Well, if we get up there, then the zombie horde will be fine, right?
Yeah. Well, the zombie horde is over at my home.
You're so good at surviving out there.
To,
It
might be a good idea if you train some of the rest of us.
So there is not co-op in this game, much like the original. So just keep that in mind. This is this kind of a nice single-player experience that has... I mean, there's a lot of hours of gameplay.
Yeah, I've put in at least a dozen of the other different modes. Hey. 30, 35, 40, depending on where you want to play.
Now, just a reminder that if you bought it on Xbox 360, just sign into your Xbox One... With the same gamer tag, you'll see that reduced price. And what Jeff's doing now is he's kind of spotting. So now you know what those areas are, right?
Yeah, I'll have an idea. There's a building we'll want to check out. A vet office is more likely to have medicine.
Right.
And also it'll mark where vehicles are, which is super handy.
That's not
vehicles,
a normal zombie.
Once they're gone, they're gone. And so occasionally I'm not careful and something will go up. So this is a great place right here. Military stash, that'll be awesome.
Now, if you have an Xbox 360 save, does it bring it over?
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
So, Undead Labs patched the original state of Decay recently. So, you can actually upload. There's a lot of ammo here. You can upload your save game. So, if you haven't loaded the game up in a while, go load it up on your 360. You'll download a small system update. And you'll notice on the main menu that you can go ahead and do that. And then on the main menu here in Tier 1, you'll be able to download.
Pick right up where you're playing.
Good, yes. Right. I started over from scratch because I had been spotted everything.
So, now, had you played this on 360?
I had,
okay.
But I've gotten further in this.
Sure.
It came out, I think.
Congrats to, looks like, what's the user's name? Wicked? Wicked41, congratulations. You grabbed yourself a free copy of State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition, so you'll be playing that tonight. We'll give away more codes in just a minute.
So you see there, there was mention that a horde was coming towards my base, but the outpost, the traps, managed to destroy it. So I actually don't need to go back.
And I want to be clear, you are pretty far in the game.
So there are five different freak zombies in the game. Big, really nasty. There's Juggernaut, which is huge. There's Feral, which is super dangerous. It's almost like a jungle cat of a zombie. It lumbers on all fours.
Hey, anybody home at the courthouse?
A new feature, by the way, is vehicle storage. You have a lot of stuff. You can actually throw it in the trunk. Which is something you couldn't do.
Might want to tell your sentries to wake the hell up.
Helps you for looting like large areas of like big packages.
Hello?
You have to strap them on your back, but you can find a house with two or three of them.
You might
throw them in the back.
Throw them in the trunk. Oh, trouble at the courthouse. That's something that's been brewing. Where they're trying to set up a new society there.
I say there's trouble at the courthouse, Jeffrey. Out of here. Apply that chopper.
There's actually. I'm gonna test out this bag.
We're gonna GTFO.
That's a pop door. I was to do this in a sedan, it would already be right. Coming up.
There's your GIF internet.
Okay.
This is Cleo.
Oh, so order here. Derived. Order. Angels order. 40, 10 mics. So that is something
posit
that.
11 Tango Mike Papa 25 Alpha 05 Quebec.
Here.
Cleo sending us
this
another
is a medicine.
Basket.
I can carry
I'll
one.
Out the thank you card.
All right, so I'm going to take this one.
Put it in the truck.
But,
nice.
Actually, I got more grenades than I
have. There's good stuff in here.
Yeah. This is actually not the big drop. This is a pretty good place. So this is actually, has a medicine stash. So what I can do, and I don't have a medicine stash, I'm going to set up an outpost here.
Here you're going to set up an outpost.
Right here.
That's not a good idea.
Not really a good idea.
Oh, I've got to be in a building.
I got to agree with her. I'm not really.
I guess you can only do it in certain places.
We go back to the fairground, which reminds me, I have an incredible hankering for fried dough. The fair thing.
Elephant ear for you, sir.
See you back at base.
The Big E.
We'll see you soon.
He is not a big man.
The Big E is a huge state fair in New England. Because New England states are so small, they have the Big E. I'll tell
you. Yeah, they all team up.
Yeah, exactly.
Go to the one in Big.
Big C. Oh!
What's all zombie horror, of course. Sometimes there'll be like a torrent. Launch.
How do you know?
I can see there's one.
I see.
One here. It's gonna be best for my headquarters if I just.
Attention, civilians. Remain in your homes with the doors locked and the windows secured. If you do not comply with these instructions, the army will not take responsibility for you being
military.
So in the upper left-hand corner, you can see. I mean, there's a lot going on here.
Yeah. So I'm all right. So I have a friend in trouble. This is the most time-sensitive thing here. So I'm going to come back, take out these hordes. So, my ally.
I'm on the move.
So you're constantly weighing like, what is the most? I'm going to make the situation helpful. I think as a major story mission is planned.
Hey, Jeffrey? Oh, we got a car on the other side, though.
Yeah, I do have a car on the other side.
Try it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there he goes.
Running radius on this thing. Better than expected. I'm mostly driving. I mean, I have those supplies in there.
All right, we're going to randomly give away another game. What do you say? Gang, are you ready? Is your body ready, chat room? Also, I want to point out there are day-night cycles.
There are day-night cycles. A few other new things. All this significant enhancements.
Is there a lot of weapons in here?
There are hundreds.
Really? There's not bazillions like Borderlands.
I'll take you through. Yes, there are not quite a million bazillions. But there are more than you're going to...
I think we can take out the worst threat.
Oh, man. He wants help hunting a juggernaut. I'm going to put him off. I do not have enough.
But he's studying kickboxing.
Dude. You've got that. Juggernauts are so... That juggernaut would mess this thing. I've killed two people. And at high cost. So, I will come back... Oh, wait. I have a grenade. Do it?
Yeah. Let's do it. You guys want it? The chat room says yes.
I'll do it. I lose Garibani here, a fully maxed out character. It's on you. It's on your conscience.
We don't need to. Well, go ahead. All
right, congratulations. What's the name of the winner?
Let's move.
Keep an eye on our.
The winner now. Rolling dice.
These guys are screamers. If they get too close, they will start to scream and they will.
Dead.
This is it. All right, so this is a SWAT zombie. They're essentially bulletproof, but
finish it off.
Right.
That's pretty good.
Pretty good, but a juggernaut is just
frightened.
Do it.
frightened of the juggernaut.
Oh, those aren't the juggernauts.
No, I know.
He's got a wrench. I feel like, or a lead pipe. Okay, the juggernaut's around.
Marcotonius is the winner of the next game. Congratulations. We'll DM you that code. Cool. Thank you for being cool. Bodies.
I'm legit nervous right now that I'm going to lose Gravani on this.
Where do we have to go?
Over here. There's a ward. I'm going to take out Marcus. Distractions as possible. Not has been hilarious. Excited over here.
Oh, if we, so you're telling me if we run into him in the car, will that do any damage to him?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh shit!
Nice shot!
Alright. Yeah, I don't know, he's still not dead. Near the car now. I don't want to throw a grenade in this.
Go through, go around.
Here we go. This is it.
Go! Yeah! Alright, there we go.
Yeah, all that for nothing.
However, I hit this guy with some shrapnel and now he doesn't like it. So let no good deed go unpunished.
But he's the one that got you into this mess.
Right? Why'd you come here?
Okay.
Alright. That actually worked out pretty well.
Hey.
So there's always
the
something.
Reason we do this is because you're. Why did we take that side quest?
Why did I take that side quest? To earn trust with that. So that guy is
good
part
work.
Of. Yeah. I think a little bit of trust. So there's a group over here of strangers that I can that
right.
platform. Ultimately, I want them to join. They will also sometimes help me out. So there's one group that, if I head over there, we usually have a stash of. If I need it, I can. So it's sort of work together, and if I don't go out, we'll die out.
Yep.
And that's one less safe zone from the zone.
Alright, if you want to win a code, all you gotta do is be active in the chat.
I'm almost home.
Be cool, don't repeat things a billion times, keep it clean, have fun, you know, the general stuff.
So here's a nice feature, if you, so I have a bunch of stuff in the trunk, so as soon as I put one in my spot here.
There you go. Don't say I never gave you anything.
Auto unload.
My hero.
This is the type of innovation we're talking about.
As much of the game is about, you know, getting back supplies and keeping your guys well rested. So I'm going to switch characters now. She's going to get tired pretty soon. You can't go forever. Plus, you need to build folks up. So I'm going to dump off a few other things in the locker, and I'll show you all the different weapons. As
yes.
you see, my morale is really high.
Yeah, like people
the
love
home,
it.
The homestead's in pretty good shape.
Things are good. Things are good. Things are happening. A bottled water. You've got a couch. You've got a locker. Whoa.
All right, so I'm dumping off.
Those are the hit points.
I'm giving stuff back, so I
don't
build
think
up
the mayonnaise.
Okay, so here's all the different firearms that I've got. Here's all those just tons of different melee weapons. I barely unlocked any of them. I've Molotov cocktails.
About halfway through the stream right now, gang. So we'll be giving away more codes in just a little bit. Thanks for tuning in. We're watching myself and Jeff here play State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition out this week on Xbox One and PC. So you're getting an early look at it. Goes on sale tonight.
So you asked how I can switch to someone. You
yeah.
can either go up and talk to them and
right.
like wine, say, can you take over for me? Or you can go into the menu if you can't find them. Sometimes they might be off somewhere. So this is Marcus. This is who you start the game out with. And I've been doing my best to keep him alive. He's a pretty good fighter. He's almost fighting.
We'll go back and so are those weapons are for everyone to use, right?
Yeah, so actually the first thing I'm going to do is go back and head over to the locker.
What's your go-to melee?
My go-to melee is something that's light but strong because you have to worry about weight. So this axe is really good. Crowbar is fine. And I do like a hat. More snacks than I need, some more meds than I need. I need to clear out his backpack a little bit so that
yeah.
find stuff, he can actually bring it back. I bring a silencer as well.
Can you customize the weapons? Are there?
Well, by silencing them. So what I can do is I can attach this.
There are some attachments.
And now this silenced for about 50 shots. The little 50 at the top. That's how many shots that's silenced.
And then how do you prepare the weapon?
What you would do, it would be silhouetted in yellow if I needed it to. If it was broken, and I would just come in here. Highlight over it, and it would be an option to hit Y.
Why would you need a timer?
Actually, a timer's really useful for...
I'm picking up the Cleo signal.
Oh, when the bell goes off?
Be careful, all right?
Sometimes fighting is not the best way. Sometimes just...
Be a fighter, Jeff?
I love our hand fighter. Not last very long in there, but...
Sure. We don't live in a barn.
Hear those gunshots? That means my sentry is taking them. It's a nice view, so whenever... End up to take them. Ally in trouble. I got some work to do here.
Yep. I'm going to go save. Are we on what's on, Rich?
I'm headed out.
Okay. Watch yourself out there.
Here, if you're just tuning in, let me know. We should be on the What's On tab on Xbox One. Let me know.
Looks like an infestation.
You have to manage folks. They may leave. Or they may take.
I got these assholes.
Yes. Kind of depressing living here.
There'll be trouble on the left.
Always safe for this. Oh, when things are a little bit crazy, sometimes you have to just say.
You got that one.
There we go. There we go. It's happening. Oh. This is certainly there's some arcade elements to it, but really this is RPG survival.
There's sort of RTS elements.
Yeah.
So there's one early mission. So he's maxed out on fighting now. There's a early mission where like you're in a oddly docile.
Right, in the bedroom.
Let's go.
Alright. Okay. So he's good. I'm just gonna escort this guy.
So you see in the upper right hand corner, you gained his trust. So what will he do for you now?
There's sort of like a meter that will go up. Exactly. So I don't have to take care of some of these engines.
Is that true? I just saw in the chat room said if you have a priest, people don't run away as often.
That might be the case. I had to shoot my priest because he got sick. So.
Priest. What about the rabbi? You left him alone.
No. He knew better than to go out.
Thanks. We got it from here.
That guy's fine. Now I will.
All right, we're on to the next step. Now, can you repair vehicles?
So if you have the right facilities in your home, you can give them parts, they will repair. I don't think I have that type of workshop. So it's you sort of have to balance. You can't build everything and then put it in your home.
Right.
So by having like a higher grade kitchen, it's like...
So there's this is... At first glance, you may not see the depth and complexity of this. And it's one of the hard things when you're a game designer is how do you make the game deep, but not too deep? So if you want to come on, plow into him.
No. You want to see what happens if I plow into him?
Should we plow into him? Yeah, let's do it.
Or just like... Not even dead. I have enough speed. Charges me, though. Oh, I don't have any. No. I don't have a grenade with this guy. I think not bring a grenade.
Run away!
Look at that car.
Exit
there's like,
stage left. Later.
Probably get out there.
That's some American muscle right there.
See how like things can get out of hand.
Well, from my guess is things can't they won't get out of hand if you don't kill your priest. That's generally what the chat room is saying.
I got these assholes. Okay. Break his fucking skull!
Tuning in, you're watching us play State of Decay, Year 1 Survival Edition out on Xbox One and PC this week.
Let's get out of here.
Jeff's playing through. It comes out this week. We're going to be giving away codes. Give away another code. Let's go give away another code. There's like about 1,000 people in the room. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Larry Hryb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson, joined by the fantastic Jeffrey Bastien here.
Look at my sports car. It's just completely wrecked.
It's wrecked. Off.
Are you happy now? I'm just...
Later.
There are two types of zombies in the game that if I see them, I gauge.
RJ Bull, congratulations, you just grabbed yourself a copy of State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition. We'll DM you the code, you can queue that up, and then it will unlock tonight. My name is RJ Bull. I choose a name to be on the internet. I choose RJ.
I'm back, and then I would say no. I can go into the courthouse. I'm going to get some grenades.
Here we are. Thanks. We got it from here.
Get hit, which is nice. This guy's the first guy, Marcus. He's the first person you control, so I really want to keep him alive. At it.
Well, that's where we all started this thing.
Yeah.
Let's go find a horde and do the alarm and then a grenade. Go to the courthouse?
Go to the courthouse.
Alright, let's take it. Okay.
I'm feeling this may be the denouement.
I'm headed out.
Courthouse.
We're
story.
Gonna wanna move quick on this one.
A little.
Crazy!
So it's starting to build. Started off friendly enough.
How do we have left? Alright, about 20 more minutes. I'll give away... Got another copy of the game to give away. We'll do that in a few minutes. We are... How far are you... So how many hours are you playing... Have you already played before we started?
10, 12?
So about 10, 12 hours in. So that we're at a fairly advanced point of gameplay in terms of things...
That ain't gonna work.
Oh, so stop them.
Where's that? Alright, it looks like actually there's some.
Things are going down at the courthouse. I say, Jeff, I say.
Mayday, mayday.
Yeah, this is,
Sheriff are dead. That's not
good. That's it. We are now living in a lawless society.
Actually, it was successful.
Forces fall out.
All right, so this is tough. supply draw mission. So this will be, I think, probably the last thing. But it's, oh, Screamer. Close, like I said, you get paralyzed and then other.
All right. Is now.
All right. It's also like a really
stupid. We have no judge. We have no sheriff. It's lawless. I mean, a Lord of Fly stuff going on here, guys. We're headed to pick up a supply drop because we want some.
Right. Yes. There. Good. Way out here. I'm just gonna cut through the farms. The town again. This is the largest town, Marshall.
All right, we are going to go along here. Yeah. Run, Jeff!
We're about
run!
As secure as we can be here. Any hordes that come our way are gonna be sorry.
Good thing is, if you keep your base well fortified like mine is, it gives you a little more leeway to mess around and to inspect.
All right.
Securing more, more territory.
All right. Yeah, so.
There. It's actually some cool stuff. Bye.
Middle of the map. You know, it wouldn't be a bad idea to teach some of your skills to other folks. It might be a good idea if you train some of the rest of us.
I'll just live.
Drove by that car with the Landau. Ooh, airplane.
Yeah. There's actually a piece of landing gear somewhere else out on the road where it hit cliff on the way down.
Now, how do the zombies take down an airplane? I need to know this.
A lot. There are a lot of untold stories.
These are alien zombies. Be careful.
I don't want to think about that. I have to go to LA. Stop it.
We're headed.
I drop. Usually they're in a rural
area.
Well,
I bet you there's some.
Oh, I already moved it.
Like pre-made meals and peanuts. Yeah, exactly. Boom.
All right, so if you kill one of those bloaters, your car will actually break the car.
All right.
That's bad.
All right, we're going to give away another copy of the game. Want to do that right now? Let's do it right now. So if you guys, all you need, don't have to do anything, just be cool, and we'll randomly choose somebody who's been chatting with us in there. Post the same thing over and over, we disqualify you. Wearing Crocs, we disqualify you.
Alright, so you see that? Oh. So here we go. There's a bunch of folks around this supply drop. I see two freaks here,
okay.
And there is over there a horde. So this can go south. Really bad.
Yeah, like, this is.
So what I'm gonna do?
What is that? Oh, they're coming after you.
There are a couple things I can do.
You're trying to bring them away from it.
Okay, death from above.
Calling in an artillery strike.
Where did you throw it yet?
Nope. Oh, crud. No.
Target's good. Here we go.
Yeah.
We gotta get out of here.
These guys, the feral that's chasing me, yeah. Are the worst.
Oh.
Now I'm fired and I'm being chased. Guy got taken down, so that's great.
Orangutan, congratulations, got yourself a copy of the game. We'll DM that to you. Tell me who are alerted. How many times can you call in the airstrike?
It's dependent on how much. Last time, so have a good. I like saving.
Coming up.
Being cool.
Being cool.
Right.
Kurt's dead. I can't do that. I did what? Lots of that. I took the ball and then I. How? I don't have. No, that thing's beeping.
So that thing's beeping?
I need a break.
You said, why don't you use your clock?
Lucky they didn't hear that.
Everything's going ahead.
Right on, gang. Guys, want to learn more about State of Decay? Hit up Undead Labs on Twitter at Undead Labs, or you can hit their website. They got a great community over there. Did a stream there a couple weeks ago.
Onchalant,
my shoulder pack.
Hey, let's see.
So I'm picturing this warehouse full of supplies and a woman named Cleo who sits at a radio all day, surrounded by her cats. All right.
Let's try it out.
Actually, that sounds a lot like my life. We need to get out of here.
There we go. Winner, winner, winner. Uh-oh. Yeah, romance. There's romance in the middle of all of this?
Sometimes you gotta take some of these folks aside. You gotta talk to them.
They're high maintenance.
That guy's getting real tired. He's gonna fall asleep. He's gonna...
We are... This is pretty much gonna be the end of it. One more code to give away, right? Alright.
All things should be okay. Should have survived.
So is there more stuff in the supply drop?
There were a few more pieces of medicine, but sometimes you gotta let them go. They're marked on the map, however, so I can, right there. So I can come back to that if I need to, and take it later. I have a pretty good supply of medicine, if I got pretty lucky.
Right.
Probably.
Pretty much wrap it up in just a minute.
Pop it on.
Here, I'm looking up on Twitter right now, guys. We're all if you guys have any questions about State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition, now is the time.
I believe I came through.
Survived. No, I had faith in you.
Once they're dead forever. That's why it adds just that extra bit of tension. Because I don't want to lose parts. A lot of time.
Right. Guys are joining us out on the west coast of the United States. You're probably just hanging out and eating lunch with us. Joining you on the east coast, you guys are starting getting close to the end of your workday. You're up, you're at the pub. Alright, two more. We've got two more codes to give away. So go ahead and just kinda hang out in the chat room, be cool, and we'll give away two more codes in about 5 minutes.
You might want to go check it out.
Oh, some survivors would like to join us. That's exactly what I was saying.
How do they find out about you? Is there Survivor Bulletin?
I might have helped. Radio. What happens in a horrible situation? Ham radio.
In Morse code. And okay. I'm free. Aliens live in the vents. They always do. Check the vents.
I'll show you when I get there. Found this while I was out.
What you got?
Oh, you know, stuff.
Stuff. Let's do a code right now. Brian 1, congratulations, you grabbed yourself a copy of State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition. Ghosts.
The kids call it ghosts.
You
can get a little bit of base, by the way. There's all kinds of stuff you can upgrade in here. I've upgraded most of them, but I could build new suppressors if I run out. Okay. This is because I have a machine shop in here. I could build new Molotovs or firecrackers, which are a good diversion. I could, now, if I had a library, which I just can't build in this facility, I could have built a medical lab, which would be great. More storage is super important.
Yeah. Possible.
For this particular, I could tear down something else and do it, but right. I have areas so folks have more stamina, which is super. So all of these menus have been redesigned. Actually, get a little clearer what you're.
Did
doing
they take anything out?
They left in all of the good.
All right. You guys missed any of the stream, don't worry about it. I'll put it up on my YouTube channel later today / tomorrow.
You guys want to come to the courthouse, the folks
yep.
that no longer
except
have anybody.
Except the sheriff.
Yes.
The ones that are still alive.
May they rest.
Is that a dam in the upper left-hand corner?
There is. Actually, a road that goes up here.
Oh, we're going to give away, you want to give away the last, we'll give away the last code now. Last chance. You know what you guys think in the chat room, and be cool, don't repeat, etc., etc. Keep it clean, gang. Choose one more winner to win a digital copy of Stage K Year 1 Survival Edition. You'll be playing that tomorrow, your Xbox One. And there we go. Apparently that's awesome. We can go. I want to go to the top menu so we can show the other modes. I mean, we're not going to show the
sure,
other modes.
Yeah.
We'll just talk about them.
Anytime you do anything significant, and then also when you quit, it saves.
So up here, as you need to see, is these are the different modes you can play. Why don't you talk about three? Don't go into them. Just
sure.
State of Decay is what we were playing.
State of Decay is what we were playing. That yeah. is more story based and has a definitive ending. Breakdown is more of like a roguelike type of version of that. Same map,
yep.
but you start in a random place, you pick a character, you start in a random place, and you basically try to build up a escape vehicle and get out, and then it resets, but it's harder every time. There's a lot of achievements based in it.
Right.
Lifeline is a completely separate story, takes place on a different map, whereas in original State of Decay, you're like a normal person, you
right.
build up a base, you build up an artillery. With Lifeline, you start off, you're part of the military, you start off in a heavily fortified base, but things start to break down from there. And you're rescuing a number of medical folks and doctors who may have an idea of what's going on, so they're sort of VIPs.
We're going to get to the bottom of this.
You go out, yeah, we can do this. And you bring them back, but then you also have to repel some significant hordes of zombies that come in.
Right.
Then it becomes sort of like a tower defense game. In the tower.
Great. All right, so that's State of Decay. You get all three of these games for one price. If you bought it on Xbox 360, sign in with the gamer tag that you originally made the purchase on, go over to your Xbox One, and you will see the 33% off price. Thank you guys for tuning in. Jeff, thank you.
Thank you. I didn't die. So.
Yeah, so yeah, exactly. That's exactly what we're what's the name? Robo Jeebus.
You deserved it no matter what.
Congratulations. You grabbed yourself a copy of the game. Everybody else, go to my blog. Redown, you know, go ahead and pre-order, pre-download this. Follow me on Twitter. You know the deal. Subscribe. Please subscribe. I want to sound like all the YouTubers. You guys are awesome. We'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Thanks.